In a letter written to District Court of Guam Chief Judge Francis Tydingco Gatewood, former Guam Solid Waste Authority Operations Supervisor Tony Carbullido is expressing his concern regarding the management of Chace Anderson. Anderson is the vice president of Gershman, Brickner, and Bratton and the receiver's operations manager. Carbullido describes a climate of overworked employees and the need for more vehicles and resources to implement the island-wide recycling program. He says he was fired from his job at the Guam Solid Waste Authority because he was fighting for his employees, as well as because Anderson felt that he was close to the governor and his special assistant, Arthur Clark, and GSWA board member John DeKnight, which he defends he wasn't. Carbullido wrote to the federal judge that he warned Anderson that providing the additional task of recycling without providing the required additional vehicles and manpower will cause overwork on both personnel and vehicles. Matter of fact, he says in 2013 it was nonstop work for himself and his key personnel, working long hours and 7 days a week. He added that when the recycling collection began, collection crews were experiencing fatigue from the long hours from 3 a.m. to 9 p.m. and then were expected to report to work again at 3 the following day. He says things got so bad, he was eventually removed as the operations supervisor. Anderson took over his position and kicked him out of his office. Eventually, he said that after weeks of his style of micromanagement and constant criticizing and listening to the radio talk shows and his negative comments of our local officials, he decided it's time to request from him a two-week vacation. Carbullido wrote, quote, "Your Honor, these Government of Guam employees I have had the experience to supervise are hard-working employees. They deserve to be recognized and treated with respect. These employees have families to support. They have civil rights to a safe and healthy work environment," end quote. He says the problem can be corrected by purchasing more vehicles and personnel to accommodate the recycling collection within regular normal working hours and hiring a local general manager for the Guam Solid Waste Authority. Carbullido's last day on the job is April 27th. He's hoping he'll have the opportunity to meet with a judge or at least talk with her on the phone.